Welcome to Traveler's Tales. I am your host, Greg Alonzo. Today I will be your guide through history as we take a look at more ancient Greek fables. Just a reminder that we post new videos every Tuesday and Friday. Don't forget to hit the little bell icon to be notified each time we post new videos. Moving right along, mythology tells us one thing while archaeology tells us another. Why is winter so cold and nothing grows? Perhaps a better question would be, why do we have winter at all? No one likes to be cold and wet for months on end, nor do we enjoy the lack of food staples that don't come across our tables. Leave it to the Greeks to have the answer as to why winters can often be deplorable and things stop growing. Our tale centers around the myth of the god Hades, Demeter, and her daughter Persephone. Let's begin with who exactly are these characters. We all know that Hades is the god of the underworld. As for Demeter, she is one of the central characters in the Eleusinian Mysteries, which promise the initiated a happy afterlife. It is also important to note that both Demeter and her daughter Persephone were central figures in the Eleusinian Mysteries. The origins of the cult are uncertain, but it was based on ancient agrarian cults of agricultural communities. This makes perfect sense as to why Demeter, the Olympian goddess of the harvest and agriculture, is so revered. One thing that is often lost when considering Demeter is that she also presides over the sacred law and the cycle of life and death. What else is known of Demeter? She is the daughter of the deities Cronus and Rhea, who is the sister of Zeus, the king of the gods. Demeter's daughter, Persephone, was abducted to the underworld by Hades. Zeus had given his permission for Hades to take his daughter to wed. One bright and sunny day, as Persephone was gathering flowers from a field, Hades burst through a cleft in the earth and abducted the beautiful Persephone. However, this was not made known to Demeter, who searched ceaselessly for her beloved daughter. At length, Demeter enlisted the help of Hecate and her torches until Persephone's location was made known to them. The sullen Demeter, who was now preoccupied with grief, and the seasons halted and the living things ceased their growth, then began to die. Faced with the extinction of all life on Earth, Zeus sent his messenger Hermes to the underworld to bring back Persephone. Hades agreed to release her upon the condition that she had eaten nothing while in his realm. Unfortunately, Persephone had eaten a small number of pomegranate seeds. Since Persephone had eaten the pomegranate seeds, this then bound her to Hades and his underworld for a certain number of months in the year. Either the dry Mediterranean summer, when plant life was threatened by drought, or the cold winter months, when nothing bloomed. Hence, the abduction of Persephone is an origin story that is an attempt to explain the changing seasons. When the seasons are cold, wet, and snowy, and all vegetation and flora wither, this is Demeter in the depths of her despair as she longs for the return of her daughter. She is so sullen that she neglects her duties and forbades the earth to produce, which sadly causes nothing to grow. However, the months have passed. Demeter is elated with joy at the return of her beloved daughter Persephone. Now the weather begins to warm and once again the earth is rejuvenated and all things begin to grow and bloom once again. This ever-popular tale has been told and retold by classical authors of the day. First it was told by Hesiod in Theogony, followed by Homer in his hymn to Demeter. Later writers such as Ovid and Hyginus also followed suit, to name just a few. In summation, the story of Hades, Persephone, and Demeter is synonymous with the death and regeneration of life. This brings us to the end of More Ancient Greek Fables. Thank you for once again joining us for another edition of Traveler's Tales. Just as a reminder, we post new videos every Tuesday and Friday. Don't forget to hit the little bell icon to be notified each time we post new videos. For your convenience, we have also posted our email address and Instagram information. We enjoy hearing from our subscribers. Don't hesitate to contact us with any questions or comments you may have. If you haven't subscribed to Traveler's Tales, please do. This really is the best way to help our channel grow. Traveler's Tales will return with part two of More Ancient Greek Fables. Until we meet again at the crossroads of folklore and fact, Karthistos.